Hello, my name is Stephen Lester, and welcome to HCM Microlessons. It's not uncommon for us when in the echo lab to be reviewing studies, and we notice that the walls of the heart, the left ventricle, sometimes the right ventricle, are thick. And when we see this, we have to ask ourselves the question, why? Now, when the walls of the heart are thick, there are three fundamental possibilities. One, the walls of the heart are thick because the muscle has truly hypertrophied, either due to a genetic predisposition like hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, or an endocrine or hemodynamic abnormality such as aortic stenosis or hypertensive heart disease. But the walls of the heart may be thick not because the muscle is hypertrophied, but rather because it's being stuffed extracellularly with these abnormal proteins, a typical infiltrative disorder like amyloidosis. Or the walls of the heart may be thick not because the muscle is hypertrophied or because there's extracellular deposition of these abnormal misfolded proteins such as in amyloidosis, but rather because there's a storage disease, or as I like to say, the garbage disposals of the cells aren't working well. Things such as Danon's disease or Fabry's disease. But when looking at the echocardiogram, particularly the 2D images, phenotypically they all look the same. The walls of the heart are thick. But it's what's on the inside that matters. And understanding why the walls of the heart are thick can have very important both therapeutic and prognostic implications. Understanding why the walls of the heart are thick is not just academic anymore, because today we have evolved both a deeper understanding of the molecular basis of disease states and modern therapeutic approaches that can be applied to them. For example, in hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, I like to say that the heart is just all stressed out. The heart is hypercontractile because in this condition there are just too many myosin motors in their open or on state. Today now, there are oral allosteric modulators of beta myosin, taking these motors from their on to off state, sort of resetting the hypercontractility to normal by causing reversible inhibition of actin myosin cross-bridging. And drugs like Camzyos are available to those with obstructive HCM and a preserved LV ejection fraction. What about patients with infiltrative diseases like amyloidosis? Well, if it's AL amyloid, this can be a medical hematologic emergency in various chemotherapies. And if it's transthyretin amyloid, there are now stabilizers and silencer therapies. If you have a storage disease like Fabry's disease, there may be enzyme replacement therapy or oral chaperone therapy. So it really is important for us to better understand and learn why the walls of the heart are thick. And I encourage you to work through this series of HCM microlessons as we review a number of case examples.